इज द स्टेट ऑफ द EGR आफ्टर 1,20,000 किलोमीटर्स. इट्स नॉट टोटली बैड, जस्ट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ डिपॉजिट ओवर हियर एंड लिटिल बिट ओवर हियर. वी आर ट्राइंग टू स्क्रेप आउट दिस कार्बन एंड सूट एंड क्लीन इट अप दिस EGR. माई टोयोटा फॉर्चुनर 2015, 1,20,000. This is the state of the EGR. First, the intercooler was removed. That is the intercooler. Intercooler was removed, and then the throttle body is out over here. And the block, everything is removed, and then the EGR is over here. Throttle body and the block, everything is removed. This is the EGR cooler over here, and then below you would have an intake manifold. These are the blocks for the injectors, and the EGR elbow over here. So we have removed the EGR, and we didn't find too much of soot inside. Of course, there is a small thin soot film, but that's completely normal. There will be small amount of soot inside, but there is no deposits, like thick layer of deposit. There is no deposit. We just checked it. In fact, even the throttle body is quite clean enough. Only the EGR valve was just having a lot of soot. You can see the amount of soot over here that has been scraped out, and currently it is cleaning up this EGR piston and everything from all the deposits. The valve was getting blocked, choked, the movement was restricted. So we are just cleaning the EGR of this Fortuner. Cleaning the EGR. This is the EGR completely cleaned now. You see, this is completely cleaned, scraped out. This was choked here. It was completely choked with soot. Now this EGR is clean, and there is free movement of this piston inside over here. So whenever there is a vacuum created, this will move inside. This piston will go inside. The movement is free. Earlier the movement was restricted because of lot of soot over here and on the outside. Now it is completely free, and this should improvise the performance of the vehicle. The power delivery was going down, and now it should be solved. So this is the throttle body. This is the outer side from this direction, and you see the inner side, you will see some deposits. So it does have some deposits over here, not completely blocked, but just a little bit dirty. The surface, the inner line surface, is pretty much clean, but anyways, we'll just give it this also a clean. This is the throttle body. We just cleaned the EGR. It's quite clean now. This block is getting cleaned, and then clean the throttle body. This is the throttle body, which is cleaned. Quite good. The surface is good as well. The inner surface is cleaned well using that spray and then gentle pressure and that toothbrush. Use it gently on that butterfly. This is cleaned now, the throttle body. Getting the intercooler washed. Slightly some amount of oil and soot might come out. So this is the intercooler. Then need to completely dry it from the inside at least, so that there is no water. It has to be completely dry from the inside. First drain out all the water from this intercooler, and then what to do is you add this isopropyl alcohol, which is rubbing alcohol, inside this intercooler. What this is going to do is this is going to absorb all the water and allow for a quick drying inside. The inside is very important, so that there is no water going inside the engine. So you add this inside over here. You will add it inside, shake it up, and then leave for drying. Yeah, so add this isopropyl alcohol inside. Maybe around 100-150 ml, you can just add it and then shake it up. I'll add the another bottle as well. Dal do dusra bottle bhi. So alcohol is to quickly dry the internals of this intercooler. So alcohol is going to absorb all that and allow for a quick drying. Pick those ko abhi pura aisa hila ke andar rehne dena 5 minute. Yeah, just move it across so that it reaches all the nooks and corners. Yes. अभी उसको निकाल दो. पहुंच गया हर जगह तो दूसरी तरफ से निकाल दो. See, the color even changed to slightly yellowish. It cleaned the internals. And now leave it for complete drying for maybe 1-2 hours. So what we are doing is we are inserting pressurized air. First we let this sit for a long time. All the water was again drained out over here. Now we are introducing a lot of pressurized air so that some water droplets could just come out, and then we will just tilt it to drain it out. So this should remove all the water from inside. There might be some kind of oil, very very minute thin film of oil, but that's perfectly fine because we have cleaned most of it. Don't need to be absolutely clean. So this is what we are doing. Ensure that there is no water inside the intercooler. From outside on the films it's okay, because anyways when you wash the vehicle the intercooler would get wet, so that's okay. But it should not get on the inside. So the intercooler would be routed over here, the hose would go over here, and now most of the fittings are done. EGR is fitted. It's clean now. EGR is fitted. Now we will fit the rest of the assembly. All the gaskets were removed, which was damaged and all that. So all the gaskets are original. They were sourced from Budmo. So it's always better to get those original gaskets, which are rubber coated. These are the old ones. We're just putting the new gaskets, and the fitting has been done now. Throttle body. So the intercooler is getting fit now over here and over here. So there are two jubilee clips. We'll just tighten those jubilee clips, and this is going to be inserted over here. This angle, that jubilee clip will be tightened over here. So the intercooler is done, and then finally the intercooler cover. On the intercooler, you will also find air vacuum line, something like that. Kidhar gaya wo pipe? Ye. Ye kahan jayega? Over here. And on the intercooler sensor over here, and these rest of the sensors would be fitted. The harness would be completed. Over here, this part is completely done. So mainly we had an EGR block that is cleaned, and at the same time we removed the air filter. In fact, we even removed this air filter assembly. We removed this completely, this box out, and under the box there is a small kind of an cavity. There is a small kind of an cup holder kind of thing which accumulates the excess of the dust and maybe drain out the water. And that was the amount of dust which was there inside, sedimented under the air filter boxes, somewhere over here, down over here. So we removed this whole thing, and that cavity was a small cup kind of thing, plastic cup, that was also removed. The whole thing was cleaned. Air filter was cleaned using pressurized air, and you can refer my previous video about air filter cleaning or cabin filter cleaning and things like that. Explore my channel. And this is like a today's big task done for the EGR cleanup. We didn't have to go to the intake manifold kind of level because it was pretty much clean. Small little bit amount of soot, but that's completely normal in a diesel car. Only the EGR piston had a block, had a lot of soot, which was cleaned up. And now we are packing up things. Good efforts by these two guys.